Hey guys, I've moved it upstairs. Before I was in the basement, and yeah, now I'm here. It's more light, so I will be here from now. And I will give you guys my top 10 lift hills. So it's a weird video because lift hill is pretty much the most boring part of almost every single coasters out there. But yeah, here we go. At number 10 we have Goliath at Wallaby Holland. So this is a intermittent, I'm not sure if it's a cable, but it's moving really fast. And it has an amazing view, so that's why it's coming at number 10. Number 9 we have Colossus at Heide Park. So this is a chain lift, but it's moved really really quick. And again, the view is really good from there. It's 60 meters high. So it has to be. Heide Park is a beautiful park with the big lake in the middle, so it's a really good view. Number 8 is Shambhala. It's the tallest lift hill coaster slash cable that I've been on. And you have the view from whole Port of Ventura and some of Spain, which is a beautiful country. So yeah. At number 7 we have Tornado at Bakken. So I really don't know what kind of lift it is, but it feels like a launch. It feels like it just go and just launch you up, and you got airtime over the top and just plunging down the drop. And the coaster is only 10 meters tall, so the lift just take like 3 or 4 seconds where it just got launched over the top. At number 6 we have Eurosat at Europa Park. So this is a spiral lift. It takes really long time, and the theme music is on while you're doing the lift. So it's a good lift to get you excited to the ride. At number 5 I have one that someone will not even place in the top 10, but that is Rutschebanen in Tivoli Gardens. So this is a chain lift. It lifts you fast up. And when you go in between the fake mountains that's built up for this coaster, and it's just a really fun feeling where you go in. First you go in a tunnel and out of the tunnel later, and just get a view of the whole Tivoli Gardens. It's a beautiful park, and it goes fast. I just love this bad lift. At number 4 we have Fluff for Norgård. This is the indoor lift. The only lift. But yeah, that goes 90 degrees up. It's like a Eurofighter. And it stops you halfway up. And there's some animatronic. One animatronic on the left side of you. And you have the whole audio with the soundtracks and just sounds in general while you're going up. At number 3 we have Euromir. So this is a spiral lift just like Eurosat. But this lift goes a bit slower, I think. And there's more theming while you're doing the lift. And there's also the soundtrack as well, like in Eurosat. So I like Eurosat's lift better than Eurosat's. Number 2 is Fliegende Holländer at Efteling. So the lift is the best part of the ride here, to be honest. It is really really good. You're going first you go in the water, so that's not a part of the lift. But when you go up and there's some theming over you, it's like a face. I think it's a bone face. I'm not sure what I have to call it, but yeah, when it stops you, and it's hard to explain what's happened because you're so confused while doing. You can't see a thing, but something like that, and just from one moment to another, you are out. So yeah, the drop comes and the ride really starts there. At number one, if you know what happens inside Cannon's Tower, you will know Cannon will be number one here. It goes 90 degrees up to a height of 73 meters, which is insane. And yeah, I don't want to spoil why it is my number one lift hill, but yeah, come to Hansa Park and ride it and find out. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you guys later.